So this video is on the body and the environment. So we tend to think of ourselves and what's out there, whatever that is, as being very separate. I once asked Don Handlon Johnson, who's a top name in the embodiment world, how you'd disprove that, what he'd say to that. He said, well, take a breath, you know. As soon as I take a breath, I'm taking in oxygen, which is coming from these trees and other trees around the world. I'm breathing out carbon dioxide, which is feeding them. This is intimately infused in my whole system. You know, the water that I drank out of the tap this morning in Brighton came from the clouds, probably a few days ago in the north of England. We have this intimate connection. Also, our bodies don't just end our skin. We're porous. We're constantly more like a wave than a particle. We're constantly taking in and giving out with the environment. So right now, being in this environment, being on the ground, being in this environment here is affecting me in a certain way. It's affecting my body, but from an embodiment point of view, my body isn't just my body. My body is me. This is how I think. This is how I feel. This is how I perceive the world. This is my emotional base, the base of myself as a leader, the base of my work, what future actions I can take. So all these things are the body, and that body's constantly interacting with the environment. It's being influenced by it. I think of it, we're more like paint mingling than separate particles. So the environment we spend time in makes a huge amount of difference to our embodiment, to all those things I've mentioned. You know, if I'm in an environment continuously which is hard, which is angular, which is unorganic, that's going to make a big difference. So you can actually feel this phenomena if you feel relaxed, you're relatively sensitive and aware. If you take something organic, like a leaf or a tree, or it could be a house plant, you know, wherever you are, and feel it, you'll notice there's a certain quality, a certain effect, even just with a second or two of holding it. Now, if you take something hard and inorganic, like a phone, and hold that, you'll notice a different effect. Of course, this is nature too, in another way, and it has a qualitatively different effect, the quality of that on my system. Now that's quite subtle, but think that you're doing that all day long in your work environment, your home environment, wherever it is. You're taking in a certain mode of being from whatever environments you're seeing and particularly touching. The key thing I'd like people to take away from this is our bodies and the wider body, we call it the big body sometimes, the body of the world, are not separate. Another key issue here is how we treat ourselves is how we treat the world, yeah? The issue of if we're dissociated, if we're not feeling ourselves for reasons of trauma or emotional dissociation, whatever it is, then equally out there becomes other. Other people and the world become other. They become a thing. They just become a resource to be consumed. And you know, that's really what's become endemic in the world. And the link between feeling oneself, noticing one's reactions, noticing how things are influencing oneself, noticing that connection and that porousness with the world, I think is massively powerful in terms of the environmental movement or the lack of that. The key connection for me between our bodies and the planet is can we feel? Because the way if we can feel ourselves, if we have that ability to have sensation, to notice how we're being influenced, we also notice how we're affecting other people and the planet as a whole. The sense of, am I having an impact here? When I do harm, when I do something destructive, do I actually empathize with that and feel the unpleasant effect of that? So the cost of dissociation to ourselves is not only that self-alienation, the lack of kind of self-awareness and emotional intelligence that comes with that, but also the brutalizing of other people and the brutalizing of the wider system, because we don't have that empathic feedback, that resonance that's not available to us anymore when we're not feeling our bodies. So I hope you see here the connection between being aware of ourselves and being aware that self doesn't end, as my colleague Adrian Harris says, it doesn't end at the skin bag. Yeah.